If you've been a part of the adventure with us over the past year, you know that a little less than a year ago, I moved from the Washington, D.C. area to the Orlando area. And a lot of friends have asked me, Michael, those biggest differences that you feel from traveling to living near the magic, what are those differences? Tell us about it today. That's what this video is all about. Now, I do want to note that I'm making this video without really considering the current situation at Disney and the closure. I'm not thinking about that while I'm considering all these different factors. I'm thinking about just a standard day of Disney being open. We will get back to those days again, so that's how I'm thinking about it when I'm comparing traveling to Disney versus living near Disney. Now, with that being said, even though I'm not really thinking about it when I'm comparing the two, it has given me some perspective because we were able to experience it as a local and then this sudden change to really can't go back to it that much. So that difference has really made me reconsider all of my thoughts, what I appreciate and what I miss about traveling. Now, I have made videos before about living near Disney and the attractions and how I feel about these things, but today's video is really focused the differences I feel between a trip to Disney World and living near Disney World. Let's jump in. First up, it's the rides. When you go to Walt Disney World, you're thinking about those rides and attractions, and for many of us, we would make a list of the different ones we want to see over the course of a day, and some of us would break them down by time. I want to go to Rock and Roller Coaster at 10 in the morning, and then 10:35 I'm going on Tower of Terror, just as an example. But when you live close by, you don't really do that too much. In a way, when you live near Disney, you have this feeling like, well, the rides are fantastic, can't wait to go back, but it's not that initial thought about, oh, where do I want to go today? Usually that has to do with, oh, where am I going to eat today? Or what would I like to see today? Somehow the rides have slipped into this secondary thought. Now, this by no means indicates that I don't like the rides. Not at all. I love them. It's just that my priorities have seemed to shift a little bit in terms of, oh, I want to go on these rides versus I want to see this show or I want to experience this area, something like that. That's kind of how my mind has shifted a little bit. I should note there are plenty of exceptions. Rise of the Resistance is a good example. You go early in the morning so you can get that boarding group in advance. So that's kind of a change that has happened as well, but it's a nice change. Next up, we have fireworks. And when we would travel to Walt Disney World together on vacation, we would see fireworks just about every night. I don't think there was a night where I'd say, oh, I don't feel like fireworks tonight, or I've got to do something else. I would want to see all the fireworks that I could. But when you live nearby, that changes. Let's pretend for a moment I'm at the Magic Kingdom. Let's say it's 8 o'clock and the fireworks are scheduled for 9 o'clock, just as an example. And I say to myself, I'd love to see the fireworks. I really would, but I've got work tomorrow, just as an example, or I've got to wake up early for this other thing I'm doing tomorrow, something like that. And those real world thoughts start to kind of intermingle with those wants to stay for the fireworks. So I've seen a lot less than I thought I would be seeing moving to Florida. That is something that I do miss. I really do, being able to forget more about the real world. I'm seeing that connection starting to be made in terms of, okay, I've got to get home by this point, so what time do I have to leave the parks? I don't like that feeling. I like just being able to say, you know what? The whole world fades away while we're at Disney. So that's something I've had to get used to. It's worth it, no doubt about it. Being there more frequently for me, absolutely worth it. But it's something that I want to try and change even more, where I only want to think about the bare minimum. I don't want to think about anything except for, okay, the time. Everything else, taxes and things to pay and all those things, those are secondary thoughts. The only time I have to think about is when I have to leave, then I can think about real world stuff on the way back. Another example of having to think about the real world at Walt Disney World has to do with Disney food. You may recall that I've said time and time again, Disney calories don't count, and they don't on vacation. However, when you're at Disney more frequently and live close by, they have to start counting at some point. I remember going to Disney and not giving a second thought to anything I wanted. Ice cream, Dole Whips, pizza, anything, anything. It was totally fine because I was only at Disney for a set period of time. It became an issue for me because I came to Disney and had the same mentality for the most part and said to myself, okay, not, you know, Dole Whip every day, but Dole Whip every other day, and that still doesn't work. So I'm trying to figure all of that out, but not being able to kind of just let go and forget about, you know, diets or anything like that is something that I really do miss. Again, the question comes up, is it worth it? 100%. 100%. Even though I've got to think more about, okay, I want to get the salad, or I want to get maybe the low calorie item, I gotta put those thoughts into my mind, but it is worth it. It is for me. Another big difference between vacationing and living nearby is the driving versus the staying at the resorts. I love staycations, and I call it staycations because we would go to the resorts and just have a great time and enjoy. And that would be it. It's amazing. You don't have to worry about driving anywhere. You go back to the resort at the end of the night. We're gonna do more of them in the future, no doubt about it. And perhaps I'll connect the other things as well, like the dining at Disney, and just kind of, you know, forget about the diet when I'm staycationing. Maybe I'll kind of limit it to that just as an example. But when you're able to staycation or vacation, you stay at the resorts and then you take the transportation, buses, monorails, gondolas, whatever it is, and then you come back at the end of the night. Super easy and convenient. I prefer that to driving. I don't mind driving, I really prefer the transportation around Disney rather than driving my own car. Now, there is an exception to that. On those very, very crowded days, for example, New Year's or 4th of July, when there are 100,000 people behind you trying to get on the same bus, being able to take your own car in that situation is magical. I gotta tell you right off the bat, your AC, the way you want it, nice and comfy, you're, you know, sitting in your own chair, all that, it's great. I really prefer it on the crowded days, having my own car. But on, you know, standard crowd days where it's not that crowded, I do like taking the Disney transportation. The next big difference you probably experienced with me is content creation. I love experiencing Disney with you, especially in the vlogs and on camera. It's so much fun. It is. It's so much fun for me to experience it with you. But it also does take some thinking on my behalf, thinking about, okay, what am I going to film as we enter the parks together, just as an example. And traveling vlogs are much easier to make. No doubt about it. You're on the plane, you're in the resort, you're going from place to place. It's much easier to create those. To create them from the, you know, driving into the parking lot through the gate, those are a little bit different because, you know, you can do that once or twice, but I like to create unique experiences for you so we can experience it together. So we can go to Magic Kingdom 100,000 times, and every time we go in the vlog, it's unique. I love that. Absolutely love it. But when you live nearby, it's more difficult to create that. I don't see this as a negative, however. I see this as the evolution of our experience together and a little bit of a challenge. And I think, you know, as we progress further and we learn to experience it in different ways, come at it from different angles, and I've been playing a lot with how to, you know, start the vlogs up and the B-roll and the slow-mo. You may have noticed some of those changes. I'm trying to get even better at creating those stories and experiences with you. So I take it as a challenge, and it's a positive in many ways. Speaking of positive changes, you're able to experience things outside of those standard areas that you experience. For example, Saratoga Springs, I hadn't been in so long, I can't tell you. It had been years as a, you know, vacation or Disney, because you want to make time for the things that are most important in those 5 or 7 days. But when you have lots of days in the area, you can go and experience these other areas, and I love it. On that same note, I wanted to mention new and unique food. This is a constant discussion and thought process for many of us. Do I go to somewhere, as an example, Ohana, one of my all-time favorites. I love it. I know I love it. Or do I try something new? Let's just call it Kona Cafe, just for those maybe who haven't been before. Do I go with the one I love, or do I try something new? It's a debate. It's an issue, because we only have a certain amount of time. Living closer, you don't have to worry about that. You can try different things. You can go outside of that comfort bubble and try the restaurant that you've never tried before. Even if you don't love it as much, you're not, you know, worrying about the vacation time. I love that. Now, this goes for more than just food and restaurants. This goes for resorts. I can go and have a staycation at a resort I haven't been to in so many years, or maybe try a ride that I just haven't, you know, prioritized in the past. You have more time to really dive deeper into the magic. We've discussed diving deeper in another video about living closer, but I gotta tell you, it really has given me a greater appreciation, and I love it. The last big topic that I wanted to touch on today is all about the anticipation of the Walt Disney World experience. I've used that expression before, waves of Disney, and that means those waves of anticipation that you feel before a Disney experience. And I still feel those waves, but in a different way. I feel those waves of anticipation before a staycation, or before a big dining experience like going back to Beaches and Cream, or the opening of a new area, or perhaps trying something that I haven't tried in the longest time. Thinking about those things in advance, rather than the vacation itself, I think about more specific things to feel those waves of Disney, and I definitely do. It's definitely a unique change, and it takes time to get used to, but once you do, the anticipation comes flooding back in very different ways. For example, I'm going to use food as an example. Let's say, oh, okay, I haven't had a pineapple Dole Whip in 2 weeks. Let's just use 2 weeks as a time frame. And I want to go back so badly and have another one. Just like thinking about a, you know, diet or whatever it is. Let's say you limit yourself in that way, you can think about those things again. Or perhaps a new dining experience. You go to Beaches and Cream, you say, oh, there's a brand new menu item that I want to try after work, just as an example. Or maybe I want to go and play the Play Disney Parks app around Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. There are different things that you can feel the anticipation for without it being the entire trip. So you're getting the anticipation and those waves of Disney from specific things at Disney rather than just the entire vacation. There is no doubt in the world that vacationing at Disney and living near Disney are very different experiences. The key is, where does your love of the magic come from? Does it come from the way you experience it together with family and friends, or what you love about a certain ride or experience or some memory that you get to recall? If it comes from you, if it comes from within, the magic just adapts. It's different, but it adapts, and it doesn't take away. Now, I do want to conclude this video by mentioning that this is a very personal experience. If you are considering moving to the Orlando area, you've got to think about it for yourself. There is no one, myself included, who can tell you if it's a good decision for you. You got to think about where the magic comes from. That's how I think about it. Where does the magic come from? When I really consider all of it, it comes from within. If it does for you, then moving close to it is no-brainer, easy one. Those are my thoughts about living near Disney versus vacationing at Disney. I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Do you agree with my thoughts? Do you think it goes even deeper than that? What are your favorite things about living nearby? Or maybe you've never lived nearby before and you're thinking about it, or you think that just vacationing's right for you. No matter how you feel about it, it's all the right answer, and I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Thank you so much for being a part of the magic with me today. Until next time, have a magical day.